Hi friends, today I am going to discuss the things related to the few important interview questions and explanation. Just a small explanation for experienced candidate in highway design field. Okay, so in this video I will discuss briefly the questions and the some explanation related to the question, so you can answer it. Okay, so first thing. So first question will be, so mostly tell me about yourself, or else can you brief me about your details and project details. So that will be the basic question, okay, for any candidate. So what happens, the interviewer will see the CV and just ask to brief you, okay. Then major questions will be on the projects mentioned in the CV. Okay, so whatever the projects you have mentioned in the CV, so accordingly they will ask the questions. So be careful while mentioning the number of projects, okay, and be clear what you have written in the CV. Okay, so then what are the challenges you faced on the projects? So if you have mentioned some projects, they may ask just a simple question like, if you have faced any common challenges, so how you faced it, okay, how you handled it, that type of question may ask. So I have prepared a separate slide on this, all these questions. Okay, let's go there. So then type of drawings we use to submit, and then IRC 38 minimum radius and transition length for a particular speed. Okay, then IRC SP 23 special publication for vertical alignment design. So vertical alignment, what is the other, the SSD values and OSD values and K values. Okay, then vehicle underpass, whatever the grade separator structures are coming, so what will be the minimum clearance required, and then cross sectional elements related, so what will be the pavement paved shoulder width and earthen shoulder width. Okay, so for basic cross section, and then what are the common checkings required for the horizontal and vertical alignment. Okay, then major influencing factors in a vertical alignment design. Okay, so in vertical alignment, what are the major influencing factors? That will be a good question. And then explain the procedure of topographic data checking. Very, very important question. Whenever you receive the topographic data, what are the common checks you need to carry out? So that also one good question. Then global companies means like few international companies, Ecovi, Ecom, Atkins, Jacobs, Arcadis. These type of companies mainly focuses on the contour, super elevation and cross section with respect to plan. They will ask for the cross section drawing with respect to plan elements. They will show the flow arrows like that, and then they will ask for the creating a cross section. Okay, so that type of questions mainly they focuses on this thing. And then junction design also mostly they will focus, means how we are going to, what are the things will be considered for the junction design. Okay, then swept path for turning radius. Okay, have you carried out the swept path analysis like that, they will ask. If you say yes, you must be aware about the swept path auto turn. Okay, how you run the vehicle for particular to find out the minimum turning radius at junctions. Then visibility analysis also one important question normally used to ask by the interviewer. What is the objective and what type of process you need to carry out? Then road marking details, means have you aware about the road marking details, like that they will ask. And then if you aware, then you just mention, means what are the codes required and what type of pre drawings required. Okay, that type of questions. Then road furniture plan, means nothing but road sign, traffic signs, where we need to keep and how much distance. Okay, that we need to mention in the road furniture plan. Okay, have you aware about this, like that they may ask. If you are really aware about, just tell yes, otherwise keep to avoid. That's it. Then types of care proposals. Okay, these are the major questions I faced in my interviews. Okay, so few more are there. I'll prepare one more video on that. So let's start to the slides. Okay, projects mentioned CV. So what I said, so whatever the projects you mentioned, okay, so if you have mentioned means higher number, so they will ask the more questions. So better keep whatever you have done and keep the projects on the confident ones only, otherwise you will face a problem. So on that project itself, you have to mention what type of works you have carried out. That also very means fundamental one. Otherwise, if you haven't done any quantity report or cross section output, then you might have mentioned that. So they may ask questions on that. So be careful while mentioning the project experience and or what are the works you have carried out. So then, how do you handle a challenge? Means just explain that I have taken the help of the other team members, or I consulted directly to the our line manager, and then we have taken a group discussion, and then we have taken a accepted decision, and we immediately informed to the client. That type of things you need to explain. Okay, so then IRC 38, very very important code. It is not only for experienced, for fresher also. So just read only first 40-50 pages on that. Try to keep remember the minimum transition length and minimum radius values for the 100 kmph or 80 kmph. Okay, if it is national highway 100, if it is expressway 120 to 150. Okay, so that table, you just remember the basic values for the higher speed, 100 or 150 or 80. Okay, so this is also one important question. And then IRC SP 23, design of vertical curves for highways. So in this code, they have mentioned the SSD values for 100, 180 is the SSD, and then intermediate 360, and then 640. How we have calculated that also they may ask for basics. Okay, and then K values, particularly this 73.6 and 135, these values they may ask. Okay, and then these are the values where we need to check and we need to apply in a vertical alignment using any software, if it is civil 3D or MX road or open roads. So these values should be remembered while designing the vertical alignment. So that's why they will ask the questions. And then what are the maximum gradients we need to apply? Okay, so 2.5, if it is more than 2.5, it won't be applicable. And then limiting is 3.3. So this type, this also they may ask the questions. Okay, what is the ruling gradient and limiting gradient for a national highway for 100 kmph, like that. So then typical cross sections and clearance details. So if vehicle underpasses are coming, so what will be the clearance required, and the light vehicle underpass, what will be the clearance, and how we are going to calculate the FRL. So that also you should be aware, because normally what happens, once you get the clearance details, and then you will add the deck width of the type of structure you are proposing, and then some sag correction, crest correction should be there, so that you have to add. So total, if it is 5.5, it will come around 7 to 7.5 meter, like that. So that value normally used to calculated by the bridge team. So you have to give the ground levels, and then they will give the FRL values. That's it. So accordingly you will design the vertical alignment. Then cross section elements in built up area, what type of cross section, and normal open roads, open country means nothing but rural area, what type of cross section we use to follow. Okay, so on this also they may ask the questions. And then what are the common checkings required for a horizontal and vertical alignment? So this is very very important question, and you must be aware you have done the horizontal alignment and vertical alignment. So before proceeding for the corridor modeling, so you must check the whether your design is correct or not. For that purpose, few common checks are required. Okay, these are the common things. One is length of curve. Whatever the provided length of curve is okay or not, based on the deflection angle, we need to check. And then provided super elevation is correct or not. And then transition length, based on the three conditions. Okay, L1, L2, L3. And then after that, these are the for the horizontal, and then broken back condition. 10 seconds travel time is achieving or not between the curves. Okay, in the same direction. That we need to check. Okay, these are the things in a horizontal alignment checking. And then for vertical, minimum gradient we are achieving or not, and then maximum gradient we are restricting or not, that we need to check. Minimum gradient 0.5%, maximum gradient 2.5%. So that check we need to carry out. And then K value, as I said in IRCSP 23, whether we are giving more than that or not, that we need to check. And then distance between vertical intersection point between, so that must be 150 meter like that. So because to make a smoother alignment, we need to check this distance between vertical intersection point. So these are the things, common checkings required for the horizontal and vertical alignment. Okay, then major influencing factors for the vertical alignment design. This was the question asked in my Jacobs interview. Okay, in that I see these are the factors. I given the four details. One is payment design. Whatever the payment design depth you are calculating, that will be the major factor for the vertical alignment. And then embankment height means in flooding zones, what must be the embankment height, and how much depth we need to maintain for this upgrade. Okay, from the flooding level. And then if grade separated structures are coming, how we are going to design. So just like nothing but I said in a previous slide, 5.5 meter clearance and deck depth, and then that sag correction, so total will be around 7.5 to 8 meter. So that is also one of the influencing factor. And then FRL details that we used to get from the bridge department. These are the major influencing factors on the vertical alignment design. Okay, so you can also do the groundwork, and you can search in the net vertical alignment factors. Okay, so accordingly you can answer. Okay, and then procedure of topographic data checking. Okay, in topographic data checking, there are around 10 points. So mainly one is center line and payment is, whatever the data you have received from the vendor, you just check center line details are not present or not, and then embankment edges details are not present or not, and then detailing at every 20 meter interval, he had provided the details or not, because if you have given more than 20 meter, accuracy will be less for surface creation. Okay, so and then details of all dry and wet channel courses, nothing but nala details and canal details. Okay, these details should be mentioned, otherwise it will be a problem for the bridge design and catchment area calculations. And then very very important check is null levels. You have to rotate the drawing and check for the null levels. Okay, and then compare the details with the road inventory survey. Whatever the data you have received from the vendor, that must be compared with the road inventory survey you have carried out before the topographic survey. So you must have measured the carriageway width and the junction details and chain edges. Okay, so that details you just compare with the topographic data, so you then will get a clear idea. And then bridges and culvert locations and chain edges with respect to road inventory and with respect to topographic data. And then junction details, and towards which direction it is going, and what type of junction it is, whether it is a kaccha road or a normal paved road or like that. And then all topographic features means whether he had provided the all electric line details and utility details and what to say, hand pumps details and temple details, because these are the things required of preparing a report. While preparing any report, utility report or else relocation plan means like land acquisition. So for that purpose, you must be referred the topographic data. So you just need to inquire whether you have provided the all details or not. Okay. So these are the common checks for the topographic data. Okay. And then contours and super elevation. As I said, global companies mainly focuses on this thing. Okay. Super elevation diagram. So just do the groundwork and be clear about the super elevation diagram and the super elevation representation in the LS, okay, and how you are going to rotate like that. Okay, so this type of drawing they may ask to draw. And then contours, mainly the contours, so what type of contours and how contours should be after designing, it should be smoother like that. So these are the common things in a global company interviews. And then junction design and swept path. And junction design, in junction design, what are the turning radius and what are the codes we need to refer, and definitions, can you see, inscribed circle, and then entry, central island, how much, okay, so yield lane, like that, some common terms they may ask. And then turning radius and how you are going to provide the crossfall in this area, and how you are going to design the profile for this fillet area. So that type of questions. And then swept path, what is the purpose of that swept path analysis, and then what will be the means software used to carry out, and then what will be the vehicle type. Okay, so that also one question. Okay, swept path, if you have carried out, it will be very easy. Otherwise, do some research, okay, and try to answer as much as you know. Okay, that's it. And then visibility analysis. Okay, visibility analysis mainly for the purpose of to find out the setback distance. Okay, so whether whatever the curve you have provided is visible for the to see the vehicle on the opposite in the same direction. Okay, so that you need to carry out using the softwares. In open roads there is option, civil ready also that might be there. So what is the visibility analysis, now we are going to carry out. And then see, this is the purpose. Okay, and then road markings and furniture details. And in road markings, what are the turning radius, and where we need to keep the speed limit sign, and then give away sign, okay, stop sign, where we need to keep. So these should be aware, and if you haven't not aware, just remember the code. Okay, and you can say that traffic engineer is the responsible person, or else I have gone through the road furniture plan and road marking details, like that you can mention. See, okay, signs, symbols, okay, that type of sign. So for that purpose you can refer the related code. Okay, there are various codes for road markings and road furniture plan. Okay, so please refer and have a look over those before attending any interview. Okay, mainly global companies, if you are more than 5 years or like that, then they may ask this type of question. If you are a fresher, 1 or 2 years, they won't ask, because this much won't be a scope for the 2 years experience. Okay, so then types of care proposals. See, lower mountable curbs, semi barrier type, okay, and then barrier type, and then submerged curve. So these types of curves and what are the locations. Okay, we need to prefer, okay, for the usage. Okay. Okay, this also one important question. Okay, that's it, guys. I hope you understood the basic concept of this video. Okay, these are the main common questions. Okay, I tried to explain as much as possible. Okay, thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel for more interesting videos. Okay, thank you, guys.